to post a lower average in 1 year was Jacques Pond, now as coach. And this game, number six, an important game is underway. The starting lineups quickly, unless they're going to make changes. Jacques Lemire is out there. Kamel Robinson, Nyland, Naslund, and Mondu. And Bergeron for the Nordiques starts with Peter Stastny, Savard, and Côté, Marois, and Lapointe. So, Mickey, this is a big one. Off near the center ice red line. Cleared ahead, Chabot and Lafleur. As you see now, Lemire has made quick changes. McPhee is the other winger. The Canadians go in looking for the first goal. In back of the net. Pile up of players and a fight started right off the bat. Will Pema, and I think it's McPhee being thrown to the ice.
Down behind that net immediately. Boy, not 30 seconds into the hockey game, and the boys are at it early, but this is the kind of thing we talked about with Quebec, that they'd come out possibly shoving or tried to shove the Canadians around. They really haven't done it in this series, but it's obvious tonight that that's what they're after. They want to go home for game seven, and this is one way they can help make it happen.
Somebody was saying to me a little while ago, Mickey, as we... Well, we'll get to that in a moment or two. We'll be back after this.
Well, Will Paymont's the kind of guy that can provide that kind of work for you. Number 27 in blue right there. And McPhee, he likes to go himself. A couple of big guys, but Will Paymont certainly on that forward line can push his weight around with anybody out there.
So the penalties, Paymont and McPhee at 23 seconds. Major penalties. So coming out, the Quebec Nordiques up the center ice and shooting it in. Here comes Slater. He didn't know he had a chance. The puck was poked right into Penny. Marois couldn't keep it in. The Canadians shoot it out and down. Curbelow is out there, number 21. Tremblay on one side, and here's Deeney on the other way. Curbelow is in with a shot. Blocked at the defense by Lapointe. On the boards, they get a whistle.
Well, there's Guy Carbonneau, Mickey, who was the Molson Cup winner here in Montreal this year and has continued his good work, especially during the playoffs in this series on Peter Stastny.
Well, we talked about shots being blocked before the hockey game. Dick, there's a guy that's blocked an awful lot of them, has done a work good job on Peter Stastny. And just every time you turn around, he's throwing his body in front of a shot from the Quebec defense. Carbonneau with seven shorthanded goals during the season. He's done a fabulous job killing penalties as well.
The Stastnys are out there now, all three of them up front for the Nordiques. Mondu, Nyland, and Naslund will try to hold them in check, but Marion is getting away. He'll go in with a shot, and he blocked it. Rebound goes to the corner. Marion Stastny, bumped by Robinson. On the boards, Price trying to keep it in for the Nordiques. A long shot by Moeller, didn't get very far, and Nyland, who blocked that drive, was bumped over there. Robinson will pass it up. Naslund is going in, Nyland trailing. Naslund checked inside the line, and the Nordiques, the three Stastnys come back. This is Peter Stastny, got it in front, and Marion missed the pass. He took a shot, it comes right to the Canadians. Mario Tremblay, he's in, faked the shot, tried to go around the defense, Price upended him. Nearing the 2 minute mark of the opening period in game six, the Canadians want to wrap it up tonight. The Nordiques look to going back to Quebec City for a deciding game. We'll see what unfolds. The Canadians scoring early in this series, or at least first against the Nordiques. Send it in again. Doré is out there now with Slager getting the pass, checked right away. That's been the story of the Canadians. Good checking, like this. Hunter, Mark Hunter up across the line, got away from a check. There goes Bobby Smith, bumped by Goulet. Now the Nordiques, Hunter passes it back in front of the net. They have to hurry it out into the center ice area. Hamel lost it. Hunter, a pass to Slager now from Goulet to Hunter. Straight in, Penny, and a big save on Hunter. A big chance for the Nordiques. They're still in there. Hunter had it deflected high. So Steve Penny has come up big again here in the first 2 minutes of the hockey game. Big save by Penny. More penalties.
Tonight's game is coming to you from the Forum in Montreal. Goulet and Bobby Smith have been penalized here at the 2:48 mark, just after Steve Penny came up with a big stop on Dale Hunter. Slashing on Smith, holding on Goulet.
And the faceoff now to the left of Bouchard, and back of the net it goes. LaPointe starting out for the Nordiques. Up to the line at center, and there it's cleared in by LaPointe. Out of the net, Penny. Penny couldn't get rid of it. It went into the corner. He wanted to move it to a Canadian player, but Nasman was covered. It came right through the crease. LaPointe shot, a high one. Wide of the net, Marois just stopped it in time at the blue line. Savard centered it into the side of the net. Robinson tied up his man. Savard again threw it through the crease. Nordiques have some pressure on now. Ahead, Nasman gets it out to Mondu. LaPointe is back, and he deflected the shot over the glass.
Bob, there was just a moment ago, as we look at Daniel Bouchard, you said Mark Hunter has the puck and he avoids a check. You know who was throwing the check at him? It was his brother Dale. And it was a check from Dale that gave Mark his knee injury 2 seasons ago that's haunted him ever since.
We haven't seen them together all that much in the 6 games where they've been opposite each other. There's Dale on the bench, 32.
You would agree with the coach when he said that he has been a disappointment so far, not playing the way we are used to seeing.
Yes, I would agree with him, but he's got some company. He's not alone.
Clint Pilarchuk, the backup goaltender again tonight for the Nordiques.
Canadians haven't had a shot on the net yet. The Nordiques, mind you, have only had two, but one was a big save by Steve Penny. There is no score. 3.5 minutes gone in the opening period. Ludwig is out there with Green. This is Green ahead to Gainey. Gainey coming to center ice. Gainey trying to go in over the line. Lost the puck, and Peter Stastny takes over in his own zone. Stastny lost it. Bouchard had to be alert, and Stastny was taking his time. There's Stastny again. He'll be more careful this time. He dropped it out to Moeller. Moeller coming up. Going to the line, he stalls a bit as Carbonell was checking on Peter Stastny. There's a penalty coming up. Peter Stastny was knocked down by Carbonell, I think. And Bruce Hood, the referee, now calls the play.
So the Canadians draw a penalty. Stanley Cup 84 resumes in just a moment. 4 minutes and 18 seconds, the time of a tripping penalty called on the Canadians' Craig Ludwig. And we'll see here, Mick, how he dumps Peter Stastny.
Rather an excuse me penalty where Stastny may have stepped on Ludwig's stick. Nordiques have not scored a power play goal in the last 20 advantages against Montreal. They're 1-for-22 in the series.
And you know, there were 3 power plays that they had against the Canadians where they didn't even get a shot on the net. Nordiques now, Sauvé on the power play. Robinson reaching out. He knocked it away. Robinson has a chance, going in. Went for the far side, good shot, but the glove saved by Bouchard. Nordiques, unorganized. Peter Stastny couldn't reach the pass. Canadians doing a good job so far. Now Goulet. And Bobby Smith are on. He's in, Goulet is. Goulet back of the net, centered it, comes near the line. Tipped ahead. They keep it in. A shot. Knocked down. Rebound. Penny is down. And the young goaltender gets a big ovation again as he hangs on.
And Bobby also looked behind him again. But it wasn't in the net.
Well, the main thing is he stopped the first shot. And that's what he's been doing so darn well. Get that first one and let my buddies worry about the rebound. He just sprawled, fell down, laid down, and hoped it was underneath him. Nordiques now with 5 skaters to 4, with Ludwig in the box. Smith and Goulet back on. And there was a rebound shot there, and Penny made the save with that left pad.
Played 5 minutes and 1 second of the opening period. And as yet, no score. The Nordiques, Anton Stastny with Sauvé, Goulet, and Peter Stastny.
Well, what do we got to measure?
Got a measurement.
John Hamel. Bruce Hood has taken John Hamel's stick to the penalty box. They will bring out the measuring stick. And if that stick is over a half an inch, Hamel will be penalized. And if he isn't, I don't think Quebec gets penalized anymore. They used to have a call that they get penalized, but it's just a fine, I believe, now, is it not? Look up the rule book. This is a very interesting measurement, I'll tell you.
Well, you see what? They've called it now with a minute and 17 seconds left.
In the penalty to Ludwig. So it would be a 5-on-3 if that stick is over the limit, the half-inch limit.
No, I think if, in fact, it's okay, Quebec will get a delay of game penalty. Because now the referee has made his decision, apparently, and it's a penalty.
It is. They're going to impound the stick. Holy mackerel, this is quite a situation now.
You talk about going for the first goal. It's a rather opportune time for Bergeron to pull this one.
If indeed that's the case, Bob, it'll be a 5-on-3 Quebec, as you mentioned, a minute 17 left. But Ludwig's penalty, as we get Dick looking at our trusty rule book, if we can find it. But
well, that's it, basically. It's a two-minute penalty.
Yep.
And I tell you an interesting thing here. Jean Hamel played the last couple of seasons prior to this one in Quebec City.
Right.
So there may be some local knowledge.
Local knowledge, yep.
That has been brought to bear by the Nordiques in this one.
That's an interesting call, I'll tell you. If indeed they were thinking of this before the hockey game started, they've certainly wanted to put their cards on the table early, didn't they?
There's not much doubt they were thinking of it because it's happened so early. 5:01 here in the first period.
Canadiens penalty, number 28, Jean Hamel. 2 minutes for having play with an illegal stick at 5 minutes, 1 second.
So the three musketeers for the Canadians, you saw McPhee still sitting out his major, Hamel, who has just got in for the stick penalty, and Ludwig, who has a minute 17 seconds left in his tripping call, and the Nordiques are at full strength.
Peter Stastny in on the draw. Goulet to his left, Anton to his right. Marouin back at the line with Sauvé. Marouin to Sauvé. They want to spring somebody loose for a good drive on the net. Sauvé took the shot. He scored! Peter Stastny, standing off the crease, was set up perfectly.
Perfectly timed, Mick. Nice play.
Well, Montreal was doing a good job, but they couldn't keep everybody out. Once the Nordiques decided to flood the zone in front of Penny, it was all over. And Sauvé did make a sharp play as he spotted Peter Stastny. See, the other guys are on the right side of the net. Now Robinson out in front has to cover Goulet, and there's Stastny in behind everybody, and he just tilted his stick on an angle. Penny went down, and he got it up into that top corner. And how many times have we seen early in this series where Quebec has failed to get the puck up that high, and Penny's made the save?
So there is Peter Stastny, who has snapped the Canadian streak of scoring first in all of their playoff games this year. And it's 1-0 Nordiques.
And Hamel has a minute and 43 seconds remaining in his penalty. So the Canadians send the Nordiques back. At scoring play, Sauvé and Anton Stastny assisting. Peter Stastny, the power play goal at 5:12. And Peter is going in again. Had it knocked away by Carbonell. Marouin, the center ice area. Quebec leading now 1-0. Got into the zone. This will be icing as Robinson is in there in a hurry. Icing called against the Quebec Nordiques.
We have just had a bulletin about the Hamel situation. It was not the curvature of the stick, Mick. It was the width of the blade. And had it been legal, which it was not, of course, but had it been legal, the Nordiques would have been penalized for delay of game. So you've got to be pretty sure. Mind you, they, with a minute 17 to go in the penalty, it would have been 5-a-side.
Right.
So we have a minute 13 left in the Hamel penalty, and chalk one up to Michel Bergeron and the Nordiques as they took a chance strategy-wise early in the game, and it's paid off.
They're nearing the 6-minute mark of the first period, 1:13. left of the power play for the Quebec Nordiques. Carboneau will try to get the draw and couldn't do it this time. Price coming out. Price, he has Slager going through the middle. Decides to rag it himself. Hooked it in over the line and the Canadiens simply hammer it on the boards and down the ice again. Bouchard covering as Chabot goes in there. He didn't know he had the puck right on his skate. Now it's not loose to the corner and Sauvé hustles in. Played it on the other side. It'll go back to him. Sauvé behind the net with 44 seconds left in the power play. And the Nordiques naturally would love to go up 2-0. Shot in offside. Hunter was in ahead of the play.
I don't know, Dick, that I have ever seen that call made in a game where it's on the height of a player's stick. Now, a goaltender's stick, yes, I've seen it called, but not on a skater's stick. It's normally 99% of the time it's on the curvature of that blade, but boy, that is an interesting call, and I'm sure you're right. It is local knowledge. It's Rommel, because of defenseman, why not? Try to cheat if you can, but he got caught.
I was going to say, that's really local knowledge when you get
you're
to the width routine.
Yep, it sure is.
36 seconds left in this penalty of the Canadiens. Rommel is in the box. The Nordiques lead 1-0. Ludwig hammers it down the ice again. Now coming back is Marois, Sauvé, Goulet, Peter Stastny, and Anton Stastny. Coming out, the Nordiques led by Goulet. Goulet coming in to Anton Stastny with Marois to his left. Anton Stastny fires it. It's up high. Robinson. Hooked a high one down the ice, and Sauvé turning. 3 seconds left in the penalty. Robinson nearly got caught by Goulet. Now the Canadiens are at full strength, and here they come. Going in, Naslin, Carboneau hammered the shot right up the defenseman Dore. Into the corner. It's kicked loose by Nylund. Back to the line, Ludwig. Shot, knocked down, Naslin. He couldn't find it. Carboneau is upended. Got it back near Robinson. Robinson bumped his man. And Ludwig coming back for the Canadiens. Turning. Starting away. The pass through the middle. And the Canadiens on the move. Led by Chelios. He fired it in. Both teams making quick changes now. The Canadiens can't keep it in. Here they come. Peter Stastny going in with Côté. Stastny took a shot. Deflected by Green. Naslund went after his man, but the Nordiques keep it in. A quick shot is blocked. Dore gets set. Let her go. Penny knocks it down, and he hangs on to it.
So the Nordiques have taken over here in the early going, and with the score, Quebec 1, Montreal nothing. We'll have more Stanley Cup coverage after this message.
Bob Cole, Dick Irvin, and Mickey Redmond in the broadcast booth at the Forum in Montreal. Where it's 1-0, the Nordiques in this crucial game for Quebec. Guy Lafleur on the ice. Lost a chance to move it out. The Nordiques leading 1-0, put the heat on again. Up along the boards. Sauvé tried to center it. McPhee got it ahead to Walter. Walter coming to center. Into Lafleur, and he's offside.
For those of you keeping score at home, read the Jean Hamel situation. The rule reads as follows. The blade of the stick shall not be more than 3 inches in width at any point, nor less than 2 inches at one other point for Hamel. Not only does he get the two-minute penalty, he also draws a $200 fine.
And guess what? He's not using a Jean Hamel model stick out there right now. So obviously the rest of his sticks are the same, but he'll probably go to work on them at the intermission and use the rasp on them and cut down a little bit on that height.
Amel and Green are the two defensemen for Montreal. McPhee keeping the puck in. Wesley into the other corner. Dore is behind the net. From the other corner waiting for him. Got the pass and starts up on the right side. Guy Lafleur got a piece of it. Canadiens. Chabot stopped near center. Slager hands it back. Nearing the 9-minute mark of the first period. 1-0. The goal by Peter Stastny. At 5:12 on a Quebec power play. Hamel lost control of it. Now the pass to Lafleur. Lafleur to McPhee. McPhee backhands it in. Coming in behind the net. And Nordiques Fuller. The Canadiens making changes. Paymon to center. Got it high over Robinson. Telios is back there. He was hit hard. Let the Canadians get it out of the zone. Play spun around. Canadians, Bobby Smith coming in. Bobby Smith. Oh! Came close. Kept in. And in front of the net, the Nordiques covering up, and Pimas away to center. He's in with a long shot. Robinson deflected that and behind the net. There goes Hunter after it. They bump together in the corner. Mark Hunter for the Canadians. Starting up with Smith, stops. And a penalty coming up.
So the Nordiques draw their first penalty. Reed, the Canadians getting a power play. Just joined the Nordiques today after playing with Fredericton. They were eliminated two nights ago from the American League playoffs. He's a tough guy. He's a disturber, an enforcer. He gets a charging penalty, his first time on the ice, Mickey.
And it was Dale Hunter checking Mark to begin with, and in comes Wally Weir. That's not the kind of roughness that Michel Bergeron wants. He wants tough play, but not penalties like that.
Naslin, Walter, and Nyland up front for the Canadians with Big Robinson and Chelios on the defense. Canadians now with an opportunity to tie it in this first period.
Bobby Smith had a pretty good chance. Second shot given to the Canadians. I didn't think the shot got through.
I think it hit the Quebec defenseman, did it? In front,
right.
It was Mark Hunter tied up with Marois. Looked like it hit Marois on the right knee. We talked about the Nordique power play against Montreal. Montreal is only 3 for 20 or 15% against Quebec.
Bobby Smith in on the draw against Dale Hunter, who is thrown out. And Smith goes with him. Savard comes in against Naslin. Big faceoff to the left of Bouchard. Bob Hodges, the linesman, drops it in, but the pass went through the two defensemen at the line. Chelios going back. Robinson will amble back there too in case he needs some help. Now Chelios, who appears more confident in every game, gets it past the center, but that one, a lead pass to Naslin, a little too far, and it was offside.
Well, you're quite right, Bob. Chris Chelios getting more confidence, but why shouldn't he? Being thrown into a situation like this and given a regular turn right from the first time he joined the team out of the U.S. Olympic squad, and certainly here in this pressure cooker of the Stanley Cup playoffs, he's continued to play on a regular basis.
You know what I think he's doing so well, Dick, is he's handling the puck very well, just like a veteran hockey player. A lot of confidence, head up, skating well, and making some great plays.
That is Price back there for the Nordiques. Savard at the board, bumped by Robinson. He has been throwing his weight around in this series. Larry Robinson. Chelios to Robinson. Difficulty controlling it. Now he took a light bump from Savard. Canadian Chabot going back with Robinson taking over back of the net. Robinson now looks ahead to Walter. Walter had to drop it. Canadians shoot it in. Here comes Chabot to shot. Chuck trying to get it back to Robinson, and it's cleared down the ice. 50 seconds left in the penalty. To Wally Weir, 8:55 left to play in the opening period. The Nordiques, facing elimination with a loss tonight, are ahead 1-0 on the Peter Stastny power play goal at 5:12. Chelios, 30 seconds left on the power play. Canadians rush up the ice. Chelios coming in. Chelios across the line, played it back nicely. Shut missed the pass from Hamel. Shut went after it, he has it. Got it back to Hamel again. Hamel, the shot! Shut tried to deflect it and just missed it. Mondu grabbed it with 10 seconds left on the power play. To Naslin, but it's stick handling to get him in. Naslin, trying to get it back. Hamel waits, gets it, they shoot it, there it is! The Nordiques shoot it down the ice, and another penalty coming up just as Weir stepped back on.
Live on CBC, this is Stanley Cup 84.
Quebec's penalty, number 25, Blake Wesley, 2 minutes for holding. at 11 minutes, 58 seconds.
Well, there you have the announcement of the penalty. Mondu knocked down by Blake Wesley. And on that exchange, Mick, it looked like the Canadians hit the post.
They did.
Another power play now for the Canadians. Chipmunk, fanned on it, scooped away. That'll be called back. It was a glove pass.
Looked like the on that replay, if we'd have carried further a little bit more, Naslin got the loose puck. I think everybody gave up, even Bouchard, and Naslin took a little backhand and knocked it off the goalpost. Everybody in the building, let's have another look at it now. Well, this is the glove pass ahead here by Pat Price, the play coming back. But it looked like Bouchard got the whistle went, and yet Nordiques had not gotten possession.
Bobby Smith, Mark Hunter, and Guy Lafleur, Robinson, and Chabot, the power play unit for the Canadians. Savard with Dale Hunter, Marouane twice, penalty killers for Quebec. 1-0, Quebec. Chabot, Canadians on a power play. Chabot to Smith. Couldn't get a shot. Bobby Smith stopped behind the net. Mark Hunter coming in to give him a hand. They fall on him. They'll get another face-off in the Nordiques zone with a minute 34 left for the penalty.
There are a lot of critical times in playoff hockey games, but when you get basically 4 minutes worth of power play time, you've got to cash in. The Canadians have only 3 shots on goal and only one through the first 2 minutes and 26 seconds of this man advantage situation.
Oh, one reason is Big Pat Price, 6'2", 200 pounds. He just took 2 Canadians down with him, Smith and Hunter, at the same time.
Canadians, Nyland slipped it back. That goes down the ice. Chabot tried to hit Robinson, lost it. Oh, what a save by Penny. Wilt Paiman nearly got in there for a shorthanded goal. Now the Canadians with a man advantage. Smith coming in. Smith to the corner. Backs it off the board for Robinson. He was knocked to the ice by Dale Hunter, who then fell behind him. And they're on the puck, and the play is called.
Well, the coach might be seeing the Dale Hunter he's wanted to see in the series so far, the way he's played in this first period. Pretty good shot right there on Larry Robinson. They both went down, but Hunter leaned right into the big bird.
Yeah, you may have heard that opening, Dick. Said, well, look, right, I'll show you. He did get a pretty good piece of Larry Robinson, and there's quite a size difference in the two of them as well.
Yeah, he's a 23-year-old member of the Hunter brothers hockey-playing family with 79 points this year, his best ever for the Nordiques.
5'9 is Dale Hunter, 6'3 Larry Robinson.
Walter now will try his luck for the faceoff for the Canadians. Got the draw, but they did not control it right away, and Marois shoots it on the boards down the ice. Penny will stop it with a minute left in the penalty to Wesley of Quebec. Robinson stopped again, and he falls to the ice. Now Robinson on his skates and moves it ahead to the line. The center is Naslin. Naslin coming in, can't get a shot from that angle. Now he falls, and the Nordiques can't clear it. Chaleo's getting a shot. That was blocked by Cote. Naslin trying to set up shut. There is Green getting ready for Chaleo's. Chaleo's looking around. The Nordiques set up the box. Chaleo's lost it. It's cleared out over the line. 25 seconds left, and the Canadians don't look very sharp on this power play opportunity. And only 15 seconds left on this Wesley penalty now. The Nordiques, Hunter stealing it. McKechnie is in there, and he breaks the goal post. Hit the post on the outside with a low shot. McKechnie. Now Wesley stepping back on the ice as Guy Lafleur tries to get something going. Lafleur going in, spinning around with it. Lafleur on the boards. Good puck control. But McKechnie grabs it again, feeds it ahead. 5:50 left to play in a period. Lafleur, you can see he's trying to get something going. The last time he was out, he got a few boos. Now they're making changes over there. Hamel in the center ice area dropped it. Tremblay took the shot to Bouchard. An easy save, only his fourth of the first period so far. Now across the line with it, the Nordiques. They go back to bring it out. Bowler ahead. Nordiques are passing the puck much better tonight. Good crisp passes. This one has just slipped into the Canadian zone. Robinson back. Canadians, two of them start up to center. Carboneau is catching up. Shot right on. Gainey fanned on it. Carboneau has it to the line. Hamel shot, rebound. Oh, Carbonell had the empty net, and he fanned on it and jumped over his stick. Peter Stastny going in, centered it, knocked to the ice. Hamel, Canadians have had some luck. Carbonell looked as if he had the game tied, but fanned on it. There he is again, trying it one more time. Mario Tremblay shot, Mario Tremblay. Oh, down goes Bouchard, and he hangs on. Great action around that Quebec goal, and Bouchard coming up big for the Canadians, coming close. What's going on out there, Mick? The Canadians seem to be in charge before they drop the first puck in, but it seems now as if the Nordiques are coming on strong.
One of the best chances Montreal has had, but Quebec is just knocking Montreal around like they haven't done in this series. Every chance they get, they're forechecking. They're doing what Canadians were doing to them in the past five games, and Quebec so far controlling play. Hadn't been for Steve Penny and a couple of those toe saves, we'd have a 2 or 3 nothing game.
As it is, it's 1-0 on the Peter Stastny power play goal at 5:12. But the Canadians on this last shift have come very, very close to tying it. Marois lost it, had to hurry it then for Goulet. He could get it out. Naslin, shot, grabbed by Bouchard. He looks pretty sharp.
He does. First giveaway by Quebec. We've seen that more than once in this series, and little Mats Naslin was the recipient on that one. Although Bouchard had full view of the shot coming through from the point area. That big trapper on it. It's unbelievable. We spoke on the top, Bob, about home ice advantage. There really doesn't seem to be any. Montreal came out, took it to Quebec in game five up at the Coliseum, and here the Nordiques come back like they're at home and they're taking it to Montreal.
The two teams are at home no matter where. They're in Quebec, and they have a fair number of fans. The visiting team does, that is, in the other building.
Yes, they do.
And you can't escape hockey talk in this province these days. Montreal and Quebec, the battle of the province of Quebec with 4:23 to play in the opening period. The Nordiques jumping out to a lead tonight. Peter Stastny got the goal. Now the points. Forced back by Walter. Nordiques. Marois just dumped into center ice. Bobby Smith missed it. Hunter is offside. A close call. Offside, it's called.
Crowd hollering a moment ago. Dale Hunter had a hold of Mark Hunter's stick and wouldn't let go. In front of Daniel Bouchard, there's Michel Bergeron. Some words of wisdom to his boys behind the bench. There's Mark Hunter. Dick had mentioned Dale, a 23-year-old. Mark, 21 years old. His third season. Pro hockey, only played in 22 regular season games with Montreal with a knee problem.
Wesley forced back by Mark Hunter now. Dore chopped it out of the zone. Warner is spun around. Slager going in with Goulet. Weak shot, missed the net. Here comes Wesley, trying to keep it in. He can't do it. Dore will wait for his teammates to come back outside the line. Then he beats it ahead. Chelios is there with Ludwig getting his pass. Ludwig passed to center. And went by Walter down the ice, 3:35 left to play in the opening period. Bobby Smith went in there trying to steal it. He fell to the ice, and three Nordiques come out of the zone. A long lead pass to Goulet is in too far. He and Hamel go to the boards together. They try to hold it. Referee standing there allows the play to continue. And it's Solvay coming up with it, dumped it in front. And Chabot of the Canadians watching LaFleur speeding down. It's in off the boards, but Bouchard also saw LaFleur and decides to hang on to that one.
Well, you can see what Montreal was trying to do there. Chabot trying to play the angle off the end boards, and he missed it by a couple of feet. It hit too far into the corner and ricocheted back to Bouchard, but if that one had a hit on the square part of the boards, it might have come back right about the red dot where LaFleur could have teed it up. Mike McPhee's been a valuable addition to the Canadians, coming later in the season. Played last year with the Nova Scotia Voyageurs. He only played in 14 games for Montreal down the stretch.
3:07 remaining in this opening period. That is McKechnie skating around. decides he'll come to the side. Savard against Mondou. Naslund and Nylund up on the play for the Canadiens on the forward line. Havel along with Green, the two defensemen. The Canadiens trying to get even with the Nordiques before the period is out. Less than 3 minutes to do it. And the Nordiques playing it very carefully inside their own line. Now Paymaw coming in. Paymaw was hit hard by Havel and put on stride. 2:45 to play in the period. Moeller is back there. Moeller with Price. Price got a pass ahead. Nordiques. Now it's called.
It's like double stop coming up to both Nylund and Price. They went at it a moment ago down across by the Montreal bench as Nylund dumped the puck in. You could see that there was something more going to come of those two. They want a piece of each other, and they have a few words as they go to the bench. Simone Nolet with the headset on with Michel Bergeron back at the bench. And the Nordiques are ready for tonight's game. Jacques Lemaire wondering, where is the team that beat the Nordiques two nights ago 4-0? There's a look at the confrontation between Price and Nylund. They'll both get a couple of minutes.
So, 2:37 to play. Here's the announcement.
Au Canadien numéro 30, Chris Nylund, 2 minutes pour avoir donné du coup à 17:03.
17:23, the time of the penalties. Nylund elbowing, Price slashing. 2:25 to play in the period now. Peter Stastny is coming in. Stastny left it for Anton in the corner. And Guy Lafleur comes up with it. He's away with Chabot. Chabot going in to Lafleur. Shot off the save by Bouchard. A hard shot by Lafleur. Nordiques out to center comes Anton Stastny. A play in front of the net. Back there, Ludwig lost to Peter Stastny and tried to make up for his mistake and went after the big fellow in the corner. Kept in by Marois. Marois shot. Rebound, Peter Stastny. Lafleur tied him up. Ludwig went after it. He's playing without a step. Lafleur is there. And, of course, that is gloved ahead.
You know, I think he picked that puck up, Bob, and had it in his hand. And I don't think Bruce Hood realized that he had it picked up off the ice, and Bergeron is very upset. I'll tell you what, if we get another look at that, Ludwig didn't realize himself what he'd done. He had picked the puck up and was hanging onto it well in time to get a two-minute penalty for it. Look, he's got it up now off the ice. Look at that.
He closed his hand on the puck. That is a penalty, of course.
Oh, boy, I don't think Bruce Hood realized it. He would have gotten the call there, and Bergeron, of course, the same angle that we were at, could see. Look at him smiling at talking to Hodges now, like, can't you guys see what's going on out there? Oh. Minute 9 to go on the penalties to Nylund. Pat Price.
1-0, Quebec.
Boy, that's the big save by Bouchard a moment ago on Lafleur. It looked like he got that right pad on a bullet shot by number 10.
Good, hard shot by Lafleur, and a big save, like you say, Mickey Byers. Bouchard, there's a shot right in front of Goulet. A rolling puck, and Goulet back to the net. Goulet left it there for Hunter, who just came very close to opening up a 2-0 lead. Hunter got away from the hill, centered it, went after it, and it's knocked him behind the net a second time in the Canadiens' Mondou. Coming out, stops, pass to Hamel, too far. Moeller now with 1:18 left in the period. Mondou turning with Ryan Walter. Going in, Mondou faked the shot around Wesley, then fanned on it. Walter went in behind the net. He is tied up, Moeller knocked it loose. Mondou going in to help for Canadiens. And Wesley with a minute left in the period. Mondou again, come out now, shooting, rebound! And somehow the puck stays out. Moeller to center. Moeller for Quebec, going in. Moeller, good on this one, centered it, McKechnie. McKechnie again, trying to get it in front. Penny can't find it. Now he does. Oh. He hangs on to it.
Do you believe that action at the other end? How that stayed out, Bob, I don't know. John Hamel from about 25 feet, Ryan Walter standing right there. Bouchard with a pad, the rebound to Walter. Bouchard another save. Wesley breaks his stick over Ryan Walter, and somehow that puck squirted loose to the right side of Bouchard. Boy, things have heated up.
35 seconds to play in the period. It's 1-0. That somehow is standing up as the only scoring play. Quebec has had good chances other than that one. The goal by Peter Stastny and the Canadians. And some great chances on Bouchard. Now Bob Gainey coming out with Carbonell. Gainey on the move. Gainey was hit at the blue line. Poked the puck in. And it's fired back out to center ice. Otey looking for his stick. He had lost it near center. Now the play goes into Peter Stastny. Robinson watching him. And Robinson knocked him down. 10 seconds left in the period. Tremblay, a shot that's wide. Here comes Gainey. 4 seconds left. Gainey will get a chance. A penalty coming up. And there's the siren to end the opening period. But on the siren, there's a slashing penalty call against Marois. So the Canadians get a chance now at the start of the second period on the power play. Chelios and Robinson, Naslund, Walter, and Smith. The five people out there now for Montreal. Into the corner in the Quebec zone. Puck comes loose. Robinson moving in, but he couldn't stop it. Sauvé whipped it down the ice. Chelios coming back. Côté and Moeller, Hunter and Price. Four penalty killers. And there's Dale Hunter stopping that pass. Robinson slapped it ahead to Naslund. Robinson again. Nordiques forechecking. Chelios getting away, skating well on this rush. Chelios can't shoot it. Naslund couldn't get the pass. Now he's after it behind the net. Price stopped by Smith. Bobby Smith from the corner looking around. Bobby Smith back into the corner for Walter. Walter is stopped. Smith going in there. Bobby Smith waits, looking around, setting it up. Quebec in the box. It comes back to Chelios. Robinson. He's forced to the outside. So is Naslund. And the Nordiques doing a great job. It's clear to the center ice area. Naslund hopping back in. Naslund got in front. Tried to give it to Walter. Robinson has it. Robinson driving for the net. Big Larry Robinson looking out front, stopping, losing it. It goes back in the net again. Bobby Smith knocked it down with his glove. Then he is tied up immediately with 25 seconds left in the penalty. Kumarowov, Chelios, that's set, can't shoot it, he's covered. Bobby Smith gives him another shot at it. That stopped Côté, clearing it down the ice.
Well, Quebec just doing a super job, Bob, of keeping Montreal on the outside.
5 seconds left in the power play. Mondu on the move. Shot! Stopped by Bouchard. Shot had it hit him. It's knocked down. Shot! Right in! Right through the open crease. Out to the line and down the ice. Icing waved off. It'll go right at Penny anyway. Marois, his penalty serve. Quebec escaping that power play rush by the Canadians and still hang on to that 1-0 lead. Here comes Steve Schott. He's tied up by Doré. Schott going in, causing some confusion. In behind the net is Schott. Just barely missed his man in front of the net. Chabot, LeFleur again, with Schott again. Schott knocked down. Schott has it once more. Good chip for Steve Schott. But so far, the Canadians unable to score. Here is LeFleur trying to dig it loose. Wensley has it before him. Schott bumped him. Paymon dumped it ahead, and McKechnie has it. McKechnie, the Nordiques trying to make changes. McKechnie coming in. McKechnie is stopped, and Chabot fired it on the boards and hit LeFleur. Here's a chance for LaPointe. He centered it. Here comes Goulet. A pass. Penny down. Great save by Penny. Chabot lost it. On action now as we start this second period. Another shot, a high whistling drive off the glass. The Canadians pour it on and go the other way. They're stopped near center. That was Gainey who lost it. Now Anton Stastny, he waits. Played it in front. Penny scooped it into the corner. Peter Stastny is stopped. left point, shooting! That was deflected high. Nearing the 4-minute mark of the second period and a penalty coming up against the Nordiques. Canadians get the extra man on now with Penny at the bench, but the Nordiques come up with it, and here comes the penalty.
Holding the call at 3:52. Mickey, the Canadians better start catching into their power play chances because they've been a waste them tonight.
Well, this is the third in a row. Certainly, if they do not, it's going to hurt them down the stretch.
Canadians now with Smith, Naslund, McPhee, Robinson, and Chelios. Côté and Savard up front killing the penalty. Marouin points the defenseman for Quebec. 1-0, Quebec leading as Bobby Smith brings it in. Smith cutting for the net, hit back of the goal, centered it. Bouchard saw that one come out, intercepted the pass. Marouin finds the opening, one-on-one. Robinson is back, Savard coming in, shooting. Picked away by Penny, he looked cool as he made that leg save. Robinson against Paymon. Chelios out to the line. Bobby Smith lugging it again, dropping it back. Robinson coming on. Robinson picking his way in there. Big Robinson threw it back, but there was Dale Hunter anticipating that play. Minute left in the penalty. Smith is hit hard by Hunter at center ice. Naslund in, dropping it. Chelios, look out, he spun around. Fans call for maybe another penalty, but the Nordiques are hanging on, and they shoot it down the ice. 50 seconds left in the penalty. To Goulet, up Quebec. 1-0, Quebec leading. Sixth game of the series. Canadians trying to tie it in this game. Then go on and eliminate the Nordiques, but Quebec is hanging tough.
They lead 1-0 on the Stastny power play goal. The Canadians have had all kinds of power play chances and have not scored. 37 seconds left in the penalty to Goulet as we look at Mike McPhee on the Montreal bench. He was involved in that fight in the first few seconds, Mickey, of the game. And as Don Cherry said, maybe Will Paymon kind of came out and kind of set the tone for the Nordiques.
Well, they very easily could be ahead by more than one. The Canadians have had lots of chances, but not great chances.
Here's McKechnie again. Got it into Hunter. Hunter is stopped. McKechnie is not. He got it to Wesley. Shot by Wesley is deflected by Hunter and wide of the net. And Shutt played it back. Green in the corner. 20 seconds left on this power play for the Canadians. They have to move it quickly now, and Mondeau is doing just that. The shot to Mondeau. He failed to make contact in front, and the Nordiques shoot it down the ice. 5 seconds left of the penalty. Goulet ready to step on. And now the penalty is over. The Nordiques have killed another. Shot coming in. Shot going hard. Dropped it back, and the Nordiques are back there. They give it away, though, and Ludwig back at his own line. He gave it away. So Lapointe goes in with Goulet, who has the pass. Goulet shooting. That stopped on the short side by Steve Penny with a blocker save. Ludwig in back of the net, lost it. Côté, Savard. Savard centered it. Hit a skate through the crease. Naslund beats it behind the net. Chabot pumped by Savard. Walters shooting it down the ice. And icing is waved off again. They're coming up to the 7-minute mark of the second period. Quebec leading 1-0. It was a power play goal in the first period by Peter Stastny at 5:12. Robinson, a soft pass that looked dangerous for a moment, but Peter Stastny in. Here is Ryan Walter. Walter cutting to the corner against Lapointe. Back in front it comes. The Nordiques covering well in their own zone in this hockey game. Robinson has to hustle back. Anton Stastny is in there. Robinson picked it up. Fed it ahead. Carbonell the other way, high over the glass, and a Stanley Cup souvenir for one of the many fans here at the Forum.
Nordiques continue to lead 1-0. Tonight's game is coming to you from the Forum in Montreal.
Bob Cole, Dick Urban, and Mickey Redmond in the broadcast booth at the Forum in Montreal in game 6 with the Canadians leading the series 3-2. Nordiques trying to get another game going for Easter Sunday in Quebec. Conley coming out. Carbonell stopped. Canadians pick it up again. Gainey turning around. No place to go but to the corner. Conley and Carbonell are in there. Carbonell, Fitz Tremblay, missed him. The Nordiques having some troubles organizing the play out of the zone now. They just get rid of it. Tremblay shoots it back in. Quebec Dore missed his man. This will be icing as Hamel goes back. 12 minutes and 21 seconds remaining in the second period.
Both of you gentlemen are likely too young to remember this, but there was quite a hockey game, an historic hockey game, played on Good Friday 30 years ago. Easter time, 1954, at the old Olympian Detroit, Mick, your old stamping ground, when the Red Wings beat the Canadiens in overtime in Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final. Tony Leswick scored the goal. It went into the net behind Jerry McNeil off the glove of Doug Harvey, ending a tremendous series. And for Danny Gallivan, that was his second season of broadcasting the Canadiens. We can report that Danny will return before the playoffs are over. Robert is doing a great job filling in. Keep it up.
And the Canadiens and the Nordiques are making it easy to work this kind of hockey. They're going all out. On the board. It comes loose. Mark Hunter could not make a play. Goulet starting up to center is Goulet. And it's Slager. He has to turn around. Slager lost it. He and Walter bumped together. Have a few words to referee Bruce Hood. Cautious eye that way as the play continued. Back into the Quebec zone. Here comes Bobby Smith. Looking at Price and he bumped him in the corner. Nordiques trying to clear it out. It comes loose in front of the net, but Price is in position. On the boards with it. The pass to the left side, Goulet. Goulet shot. Didn't get through. Chelios blocked it neatly. Chelios is hit by Slager. Aslan starting away. Now starts to move it quickly. Nyland with him. Nyland coming in. Shot off the leg and missed the net. Naslin now. Naslin. Chelios. Shot. Hit the goal post.
Uh-oh.
Hit the goal post. Chelios. Hit a man with it. What a scramble. And finally the play is called.
Look out. Marouin Nyland with the sticks up. I don't know how that didn't go in, Bob, but the puck was in the crease and everybody thought it was in. It looked like it rolled against that far post, and then Lapointe in the crease grabbed it with his hand and threw it out.
Two key things, Mick, in that sequence. The shot that hit Marois, and then Lapointe with the hand seemingly on the puck for ever so short a time. Right
Nyland.
Here, watch it.
It was Nyland that took the shot, hit the post, and there's Lapointe loving it out of the crease.
Was he in the crease?
If the puck was in the crease, he wasn't. Now what? There it is. Hit that post, hit the other post, and there's right there where he scooped it out. And again, Chelios had a second rap at it, and then Nyland came down on top of the Quebec defenseman and Bouchard, and they break that up in a fine round of applause here. Canadians having problems scoring goals. The series taking some funny bounces.
Well, the line of Mondu, Naslin, and Nyland making things happen, but it's still 1-0 Nordiques.
So close to a penalty shot situation. And that scramble, you fall on it or put your hand on it in the crease, of course, the penalty shot. But no harm done. Run high over the boards at the far side. Still 1-0. Quebec.
This program is copyrighted and restricted for the private use of our audience. Any reproduction, retransmission, distribution, or exhibition in whole or in part without the express written consent of the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation is strictly prohibited.
Well, once again, there's that double goalpost. Nyland hits the other post. He got knocked on his rear end. And there was Lapointe scooping it out. Nyland now having some words with his line mates, trying to figure out how are we going to beat Bouchard.
Ludwig now, a shot didn't get through. Tremblay a shot that did. Easy save for Bouchard. But the Canadiens, the stronger of the two teams at this point in the second period, and they're pressing for the tying goal. The Nordiques relieving the pressure, Anton Stastny. A pass to Peter to Marion. Marion shot, that hit the outside of the goal post. On the low backhander. Peter, Anton, and Marion Stastny, with Gainey holding it. Gainey got it loose. Peter Stastny stole it. Anton and Dore picked up by Penny. Wesley kept it in. There goes Marion Stastny. Peter Stastny to Marion. Carbonell checked him. Here's Anton Stastny. Anton lost control. Anton hooked it high on the glass. A little too high. And it's into the crowd.
10:01 remaining. Second period, Stanley Cup 84 resumes in just a moment. Peter Stastny, a power play goal at 5:12 of the first period, the only scoring play. Shots at this point, 15-12 for Montreal. Robinson has to go back. Naslund is there. Mondu stopped at the line. Naslund there again. Backhands it down the ice. Price and Moeller are the two defensemen for Quebec. Savard is up front, losing it to Naslund. What a sweet play he made. Shot deflected high over the glass.
Isn't that something? Naslund like a magician out there. One of the smaller guys on the ice as well, only 5'7". And he put on a show there. Watch this little deke he puts on so far. That'll teach him to play the puck and not the body. And unfortunately for Naslund, he wound up with that slap shot and got it deflected up in back of Bouchard. The two smallest guys on these hockey teams, Sauvé for Quebec and Naslund for Montreal, two of the most exciting players in this series.
Puck dropped in. Nordiques come out. Goulet to center. A little bit of room there, but he elected to pass it to the far side. Robinson against Slager. Waller hit hard by Dale Hunter over there. Goulet to Dale Hunter. Dale Hunter is bumped by Bobby Smith. Slager trying to dig it out for Hunter. Smith is there too. There's Hunter with the puck. Centered it. Hit the side of the net and bounce behind the goal again. And the Canadians fighting for possession in their own zone. Get it out. Walter missed it. 9 minutes to play in the second period. 1-0. Quebec, this is a close one. And a lot riding on this one. The Canadians could move on against the Islanders. The Nordiques want another shot at it Sunday night. Down to Anton Stastny. Coming in. Dropped it. Marion can't shoot it. Nobody over in front of Penny. Carmenol to the line. Three Nordiques are in the center ice area. Wesley, one of them. So he shoots it ahead. Marion Stastny was stopped. Tremblay, he was bumped on the boards. Gainey from center. Back to Robinson. Robinson looking over this way for Tremblay. He fed it in. Carmenol on the move. Carmenol has it. Centered it through the crease. Here comes Bouchard out of the net. Knocked it in for Wesley. Marion Stastny. Look out! A rush for Peter. Coming in, Peter Stastny. He was stopped. Good play by Green. Robinson hustling back. Another shot into the crowd. That one goes.
With the score, Quebec 1, Montreal nothing. We'll have more Stanley Cup excitement after this message.
Faceoff deep in the Canadian zone. Nordiques 1, Canadians nothing. Savard on the draw, very quickly and back to the net. Savard trying to get it out. He did, but Nyland was there. To Naslund, Mondu, tied up by Wilf Paimon. Nordiques. Puck hit Price. The bowler had to go behind the net again. Coming out against Nyland to the line. McKechnie nearly handed that one to Naslund. Bowler will try it one more time. Price. Ahead it goes. Nordiques just pushing to center. Savard nearly got through, but Mondu got a piece of it trying to get away. Naslund missed it. Moeller fired it in for McKechnie and coming out is Chelios. Chelios lost control. Naslund. Naslund up the line, kept it in. Bouchard comes out of the net. Bouchard hurrying back in. Hunter was there, luckily for the Nordiques, to tie up his man before he could make a play. Bouchard leaving the net, turned his back on the play, and nearly got trapped. 7 minutes left in the second period. Here's McPhee through the middle. McPhee and Chabot. Fee shot, deflected away from the net. Goulet hustling back. Lafleur watching him moving. Goulet got it to center, that's all. Nordiques had to go back. Marois to Lapointe. Little shaky pass on his skate, but not much with it. 6.5 minutes remaining in the second period. 1-0 is the score. The Nordiques leading. There goes Lafleur. Just missed the pass. Again, Bouchard out of the net. It's hammered high on the glass, down the ice. It'll be icing. Green going in. Goulet with him. And icing is called.
This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Montreal. In St. Louis, Bernie Federko has scored, and the Blues have taken a 1-0 lead over the Minnesota North Stars in that Norris Division game, a win for Minnesota, and that was all over. Here's what the crowd was upset about, Mickey.
Well, Goulet had a hold of it. Green was beating his progress down the ice. Fortunately, Carbon will go back to touch it before Goulet, and they were screaming here for a penalty call on Michel Goulet.
Carbonell got the draw, Ludwig shot, got by Bouchard, rebound was there. Mario Tremblay was upended, the play comes out though, and Côté fired it in. Ludwig missed it, Carbonell, Pagini didn't see it. Doré takes a look back, steps to center, bumped the high one in for Robinson, Côté goes in on him. Tremblay gets it to the line, Wesley shot, away wide of the net, Ludwig. Scooped it out on the boards. Nordiques dumped it back in. Two teams have got to be tiring now at this hectic pace of the second period. 5:40 remaining in the period. 1-0 Quebec. Côté bumped by Gainey. Out of the net. Steve Penny going the smart way with it. Up to Gainey, but look out. Peter Stastny into Marion. Marion knocked down and cannot reach it. Just out of his reach. Two Canadians at center. Tremblay is coming in. There's Carbonell. His shot blocked by Lapointe. Canadians defensemen were blocking many, many shots in Quebec City. That has turned around here tonight. The Nordiques themselves are blocking a lot of shots. 5 minutes to play in the period. 1-0 Quebec. There goes Bobby Smith. Smith against Marois. Smith stopped by Marois. And the big defenseman takes it to the corner. Goulet. Chelios stopped him. Nordiques clear. Anton Stastny. Anton going in on Green. Shot. Green blocked it. Penny grabbed it. Dale Hunter went over there. And there are about three Canadians all over him,
including his brother. That's Mark. He left the scene very quickly where Dale was involved, and he grabbed Pat Price. Dale Hunter running into goaltender Steve Penny. It always causes some extracurricular activity when that sort of thing happens. And we are going to have penalties as Hunter makes his way to the penalty box. Here it is, Mickey.
I don't know that this was an intentional check by Hunter. He was thrown off stride, I think, right in front by Carbonell. You see 21 coming through, and he did get a pretty good piece of Penny, but not as intentional as it might have been with Dale Hunter, so they'll both get a rest.
You heard the announcement. 15-20. So then, 4.5 minutes left in the period as the Nordiques go back to pick it up. 1-0, Quebec leading it. Bowler and Pike, the two defensemen, get it ahead. Savard and McKechnie are coming in. Savard on Hamel, tried the backhand shot, and he knocked it down. Went after the rebound himself, but Bobby Smith was there to take it away. Hamel from the other side decides to go back again. Coming out, Naslin hopping to center. In over the line he goes. Naslin lost control of it. And Peter Stastny turning with two other Nordiques coming out with McKechnie and Lapointe. McKechnie to Lapointe. Lapointe shooting. That is blocked beautifully by Hamel. He got it ahead. Gainey. Carbonell in front. Gainey. And his shot is blocked. Now the Nordiques, three of them, get going the other way. And it's Marois. Marois tried to go in. Here's Peter Stastny. With McKechnie. And he watched them all the way and came out big. 3.5 minutes left in this period. And what action. 1-0 Quebec. Carbonell dropped it. Gainey lost it. Robinson puts in a shot. Robinson again. Robinson behind the net. Robinson again. Another shot. Bouchard down to the line. Green still in there. Finally, Bouchard hangs on. Never seen something like this.
That's great stuff. That really is.
Never seen anything like
this. No, sir, I haven't. Both coaches got to be pulling their hair out right now. They're four on four.
with Hunter and Chelios in the box, and they're going from end to end, puck bouncing like basketballs around the cage. The goaltenders are scrambling, and both teams coming so close to scoring. Bouchard in the last play as Robinson made a fine play to come out in front, and Bouchard made the original stop, and then the scrum was on. See Gainey trying to take a whack at it. Nobody knows where it's at. Green holds it in at the last minute with Sauvé, and they're all over the place.
What effort. And still you come up empty. Ludwig's shot was wide. Green kept it in. Now Moeller toward Quebec.
A pass ahead. Could be a break. Coming in. Primo Penny outcast him. Reached out with the big stick and made the big save. Canadiens Lafleur. He gets a little bit of room. Has to stop goal. Beats it over on this side with 2:35 to play. In the second period, McPhee coming in. McPhee on the boards. McPhee back to the net with it. Bouchard dancing out. This could be another break for Quebec. The Canadiens changing. Savard shot right off. And he jams the pass in that one. And he's going to go by Hunter. You're going to see something out, folks. Hunter just finished the penalty. Now that came from running into the goaltender, and on that occasion there is Hunter again. The pesky Hunter now has four or five big halves all over him.
Well, Steve Penny, the smart one in the group, he just vacated the zone. He got out of there after making the save. And this time it's Green and Hunter that are all tied up. Chelios is in there again. We're going to get more penalties. There's Hunter now having words with Penny. Off the moorings, or at least one of them, and they had it spun all the way around.
Our Stanley Cup playoff action continues in a moment. Well, Hunter is an aggressive hockey player, and he was doing the right thing, going in looking for the rebound.
Oh, yeah.
Sure. And as you said, Mickey, Big Green bumped lightly with the goaltender, and there was Hunter in the middle of things, and you saw what happened. 2:10 left in the period, and Konstasny stealing the puck. Got away from Ludwig's check, but lost the puck as he did. Now he's taking right and left hands from Ludwig, and Konstasny trying to fight back.
But Anton Stastny is a pretty strong boy himself, Bob. And Craig Ludwig is a big, tough guy, and Anton Stastny holding his own with number 17. I was watching the play in the corner with Carbono when that broke out behind Steve Penny. Ludwig cut.
I think so.
It looks like he's cut over the eye, and I wouldn't be surprised if possibly a stick came up. See if we can catch it here. Ludwig gives Anton Stastny a shot. Not much of a body check. There you see him wrestling. Let's see if he gets clipped somewhere. There's a little stick. No, he didn't there.
I think it had stirred it before any cut developed. I think it came after. Maybe a helmet, I don't know.
Well, he may have caught him with a punch. Anton Stastny, not known as a fighter, but he certainly handled himself well there with Craig Ludwig, who's a tough guy. Michelle Bergeron waiting for the penalty calls. I'm sure they'll get 5 minutes apiece for fighting. Let's see if we can hear the announcement.
The penalties to Quebec number 20, Anton Stastny, to Canadiens number 17, Craig Ludwig. 5 minutes each for fighting at 17 minutes, 59 seconds.
17:59, major penalties to the two teams. And Green and Hunter have a minute 40 left in their penalties. But this is going to be tough on Canadiens because for the rest of this period, they only have the five defensemen, and now one of them is in the box.
Larry Robinson has played a lot of hockey tonight. He looks a little bit tired, Bob.
Price, shot. That's wide. On the other side, Moeller shot. That stop, rebound. Peter Stastny takes his time, looking around, gets it out to Price. He had a shot blocked by Carbono. Carbono feeds it ahead. Gainey couldn't knock it down. Minute 20 left for the penalties. These are the minor penalties to Hunter and Reef. That is Peter Stastny on this side to Price. Price
took a swing at it and missed it. Now up the line, it's out over. Yes, it is.
Good call.
Yep.
Very sharp call by John D'Amico. It wasn't out by much. Veteran John D'Amico.
Veteran is right. 186 career playoff games for him tonight. Matt Pavlich is number one with 220, and Neil Armstrong, number two with 198. They're both retired from linesman duties, so you can look to D'Amico to catch up.
You talk about some strong players on the ice. This guy's probably one of the strongest men on the ice on any given night.
1 minute and 20 seconds left of the second period. Pass ahead to center ice. Lapointe to Côté. Didn't see that pass come in. Too late. Quick by him. Nasman back in with Mondou. That's broken up at the Quebec line. And Hamel goes back. And now we have a minute left in the period. So Robinson comes to center. Robinson picking his way in. He made a good rush a minute or so ago, nearly had one for Canadians, but the only scoring play to Peter Stastny in the first, a power play goal at 5:12 of that opening period. Robinson now again. Robinson coming in. Robinson still rags the puck, going back to the net. Big Robinson, a good rush again. Robinson still has it. Back to Chelios. Couldn't shoot it. Chelios to Robinson. Rebound is there. Carbonell in front, a penalty coming up. Robinson shooting, and Bouchard stops it. But here comes the penalty to Dore, I think, of the Quebec Nordiques.
Well, again, Montreal putting on some great pressure as Penny got out of the net on the delayed call. Big Robinson again, he's tired. He's going towards that Montreal bench with only 16 seconds to go. Andre Dore is the culprit on the play. I didn't see the call, Bob, watching the puck back at the blue line. It happened in front of the net. And there it is. Right there. He really decked Chelios, didn't he? Little Nasman, 26, out in the slot there. Just missed that pass. He'd have been all alone in front of Bouchard. So that's the fourth straight penalty to the Quebec Nordiques. And Montreal has been yet to crack the armor of Daniel Bouchard. There's a break to be had here with in Quebec. It's the fact that there's only 16 seconds left, and it's really not a whole lot of time for Montreal to set up, although the faceoff is deep at Quebec zone.
Well, Robinson, we have been talking about people getting tired, or the fact that they should be getting tired, but he has made two tough rushes in this second period. And this moments ago, his second all the way from end to end. Chelios now. And again.
It's going to be interference call because Montreal had possession of the puck.
So?
And I think that's what's going to be. An interference call to Bobby Smith, I believe.
That is so not that, a great penalty for the Canadians to be taking with 12 seconds left in this period.
Well, that certainly takes away any steam they might have had. 4 seconds elapsed. The time play started right off the faceoff. It was Smith taking the draw. Let's see what he does here. Yes, sir. He did impede Savard's path back to the point. So we're back to four skaters aside now with only 12 seconds to play.
Two minutes for interference at 19 minutes and 48 seconds.
Just 7 seconds left in the period now. A chance for Green. And he messed with that low shot. Chelios from this angle. He had a shot blocked at the siren. And a fight started to the left of Bouchard.
Look at this. They got both clubs coming on the ice. Look
this
out.
This is bad.
Look out.
At the siren. Everybody is on the ice.
Look out. Nyland is after somebody in back of the pack. And away they go. Spare goaltenders. Everybody's on there now. And the melee starts. Sevigny right in the middle of it with Malarchuk, and there is a pileup down there that is dangerous because somebody could get hurt.
Now you notice the referee Bouchard, he will not get
look
too
out, look at this. Sevigny and Malarchuk, Bob, are going at it. The two spare goalies down in the corner.
Bruce Hood is standing back there, you notice, and he is
assessing the situation that he's going to have to hand out a heck of a pile of penalties when this is all settled away. I'll tell you.
No, interestingly enough, Dale Hunter and Anton Stastny, look at this. This is Peter Stastny and Marion Tremblay now. Fights are breaking out everywhere. Dale Hunter, Anton Stastny are on the Quebec bench. And if they leave that bench, they could be suspended. So they're being held there by the trainer. And now I don't know who's all fighting with who, but there's about four of them down in the front. Tremblay and Peter Stastny, Nyland and Moeller. And boy, are they going at it. Hodges turning the them apart.
There are 14 different fights, or nearly fights, going on at this one time. There's 14 pairings.
Boy, Randy Moeller, Bob, it looks like from up here is cut wide open. It's underneath the top of that helmet. It looks like some blood on him. And he's tied up with Nyland. And Hodges is just going to say, all right, you guys, you want to go? Go. There's no way you can stop him. Malarchuk and Sevigny are still going at each other down along the board. That's Moeller and Nyland you're looking at. Because Moeller, I can't tell, but he looks like he's been cut in the forehead. And he really wants Nyland badly, I'll tell you what.
Green, this or Ludwig rather, has just left the far side to come on the ice.
This is really getting ugly, I'll tell you right now.
Michel Bergeron is upset down there over something.
Look at this again. There they go again.
Going at it over there.
Somebody's hurt down there now. That was Schlager who...
Hamel.
John Hamel.
Is on the ice.
Look out. Look out now.
John Hamel. Great hockey series has been spoiled with this eruption at the siren of the second period.
John Hamel, Bob, is down face first. And I think it was Schlager who popped him, and they've got him already to the Quebec bench and into the dressing room and out of there. There goes Schlager down the hallway towards the Quebec room. This is unbelievable. Unbelievable.
I think, and I hope at the same time, that Bruce Hood has finally got some sense talking to these people.
I don't think he has yet. They're still trying to get at each other. I can't tell if Moeller's cut, Bob, down there. Number 21 he's got red on by that helmet. And I don't know if he's been cut or what. Yes, he has. Boy, his face is full of blood down there. And there is Montreal trainer Gaétan Lefebvre looking at John Hamel. He is down and looks like he's out of it.
Moeller is cut over the eyes at the bench. And he is receiving some attention from the trainers for the Quebec Nordiques. And they now appear to be in a let's talk it over mood and get back to the rooms and resume a hockey series that up to this point has been so emotional, yes, but it has been great for the hockey fan. I'm sure the hockey fan does not relish what they see here now on the Forum ice.
Well, you see a lot of mealing around after the end of periods, but seldom do you see this kind of a breakout, but I guess you could almost see this coming. There's where Hamel and Schlager are tied up. D'Amico is between them, and Mario Tremblay's in there, and oh boy, did Schlager caught John Hamel with a left hand, and Hamel obviously not expecting to get hit, thinking that he was tied up as well as Hamel was by the linesman, and he just decked him, and I wouldn't be surprised if he's out cold. He has not moved yet.
I know they're sitting at home now, and they're saying, well, what happened to John Hamel? Well, I know commentators are supposed to have sharp eyes, and you're supposed to be able to relate exactly what has happened, but so many pairings. I think I counted 14, Mickey, at one time. And I honestly didn't see how Hamel got injured to the extent that he appears to be.
Well, you know what happens in a case like that is a fella thinks that the fight is over. He loosens up his grip on the other player, thinks that the linesman's got him tied up as well. And then the other guy
realizing that he wants to get that last punch in, really fires it, and the other guy not expecting it, of course, can get seriously injured. And let's hope John Amell is not injured, but boy, Slager really caught him with the left hand. John Amell now slowly getting to his feet with the help of Dr. Kinnear, Gaetan Lefebvre. He's really been out, Bob. You can tell by looking at him now, he may not even know where he's at. Here once again, look at the left hand by Slager. You see, and Hamel takes it on the right side of the face and just has no idea that it's coming because they had been wrestling along that far boards. And as you pointed out, there were several pairings all over the place, and hard to watch them all at once. And John Hamel now getting to his feet and getting a fine hand from the fans here.
So it was that blow, apparently, knocked Hamel out.
No question about it. As I say, I think he figured the fight was over and he had loosened up and relaxed, and then Slager propped him that last punch as they were breaking up and really KO'd him.
If there is a bouquet that you can pass, you have to look down at the men in the striped shirts now, because that was a frightening scene at the siren when the two teams poured onto the ice, Bruce Hood, John D'Amico, and Bob Hodges. They've settled for now. It's 1-0, Quebec. Our Stanley Cup playoffs continue shortly with our second intermission. This is Buck's bad blood.
Here. It's Hunter. I'll tell you what, they're after Louis Slager, Bob.
Oh, here she goes again.
Wally Weir, McPhee, and they're going to team up, and they're after everybody. They're after Slager. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. And here goes Dale Hunter and Sevigny are at it over there on the far side. Don't tell me we got to go through this again. We haven't even started the play in the third period. Still 20 minutes on the clock. And it started out, Bob, as we expected.
Jacques Lemaire just made a heck of a move over there. He grabbed Carboneau by the sweater and pulled him toward the bench. Jacques Lemaire standing over there on the Canadiens bench. Trying to get some sense into this situation here, the sixth game of the series.
They went after Louis Slager. They're still announcing. Now here goes again. Mark Hunter trying to get at him. Bruce Hood is just having a tough time, boy, I'll tell you.
Mark Hunter swings his stick at Slager.
He's trying to get at Slager.
Sevigny is punching Dale Hunter.
They're going at it.
The referee, Bruce Hood, is trying to get them all apart, and I think he is going to send the teams back to the dressing room.
I'll tell you what.
Here, without getting the third period started at all.
Mark Hunter, I'll tell you what, they better keep an eye on Mark Hunter. Bruce Hood is taking the charge between these two, and Mark Hunter is trying to get at Louis Slager, obviously, for the punch he laid on John Amell, who has not returned to the ice.
And through all this, the PA announcer continues his duties.
Well, he just got finished, Bob, announcing all the penalties at the end of the second period. Now look at, here comes Hunter again. He's coming after Louis Slager. Look out. Now Dale Hunter and Mark, look at, Mark grabs Dale, look out. Keep. Here they go.
This is a brawl to end all brawls.
Dale and Mark Hunter, Bob, were almost at it, two brothers. Now they're right over by that. Look at Michel Bergeron trying to keep Hunter and Slager apart.
Now, I want to point out that Michel Goulet has got a headlock on Slager, and they now got him off the ice and into the dressing room.
Yeah. I'll tell you what. This is incredible.
Mark Hunter comes diving in on top of two players who are on the ice.
You know, they got Larry Robinson's been involved now. Actually, you know, this, I don't know if it's going to be any good for anybody, but it certainly cannot help the cause of the Montreal Canadiens. They're down to at least maybe three, maybe four if they're lucky. We don't know yet if Ludwig has been thrown out of the game or what he got in the fight at the end of the period, but
Mario Tremblay is being escorted by the referee Bruce Hood to the far side. I think he's gone.
It was Mark and Dale Hunter that were at it down there. Mark jumped on top. They finally got Bob. They got Tremblay right over to the bench. Nyland is
he's come out of the dressing room, if you can believe that, standing over by the Montreal bench.
Number 30, Clint Marlichuk, 5 minutes for fighting. Number 32, Dale Hunter, a double minor for roughing. Number 21, Randy Muller, 5 minutes fighting, 10 misconduct. Number 26, Peter Stashny, 5 minutes fighting, and a game misconduct. Number 12, Louis Slager, 5 minutes for fighting, and a game misconduct. To the Canadians, number 33, Richard Sivigny, 5 minutes for fighting. Number 21, Guy Carbonneau, 2 minutes for roughing. Number 30, Chris Nyland, 5 for fighting, another 5 for fighting, 10 misconduct, and a game misconduct. Number 14, Mario Trable, 5 for fighting, and a game misconduct. Number 28, Jean Hamel, 2 minutes for roughing. The time of the penalties, 20 minutes.
All right, these were the original penalties. Let's take a look at Bruce Hood now to make sure that nothing else erupts here while we try to pass the, well, the majors along to you. Nyland got a fighting for major, plus a second fighting major, a misconduct, and a game misconduct. Tremblay, a fighting major, and a game misconduct. Peter Stastny, a major and a game misconduct. Slager, a major and a game misconduct. These are the game misconduct penalties, and there will be more.
Well, they've already taken McPhee out. He started the fight right off the bat here in the second period, but we'll have to wait another bunch of time, I'm sure, before they get this straightened out. Right now, there seems a calm, but who knows what's to come.
From the Forum in Montreal, this is Stanley Cup 84 on CBC. Robinson with Mondou and Chelios for Canadians. Marois, Lapointe, and Savard. So it's wide open. Three skaters apiece, and you know anything can happen in a situation like this. Robinson starting out. 1-0 Quebec. Robinson taking full charge. Robinson took a weak shot. It's deflected by Marois. Down goes the Canadian player, Mondou. A two-on-one for the Quebec Nordiques. Chelios, however, catching up and offside on the play was Lapointe.
Before this all broke out, Bob, there were two guys serving penalties. Dory and Bobby Smith and the Canadians, just 4 seconds apart. Try to look at that clock and figure out who's going to be an advantage here in a minute and 7 seconds. Dory's penalty is up, and that'll be 4-on-3 for Quebec. Smith will not be able to come on the ice until there's a stoppage of play because there's two other Canadians in, Hamel and Carbonneau. Smith is only 4 seconds behind Dory, the expiration of his penalty.
Few changes now. Naslin, a speedster, Green on there with Robinson. Price back there. Wesley. And this is McKechnie. McKechnie coming on. McKechnie hands it off. Wesley! Shot great at Penny. 1-0 is the score. Quebec, the only goal. Way back in the first. Naslin doing a few tricks. Naslin coming in. Naslin in the corner, bumped by Wesley. McKechnie can really go if he gets some room. McKechnie coming to center. Here's Robinson back there. The shot fired at Penny. The rebound. McKechnie couldn't get there in time. Robinson went off stride. Naslin again. There's still three skaters aside in a 1-0 game. Naslin coming in. Had it hooked away by Sobe. Naslin looking a bit tired. Rushing to the bench. Chabot is on there in his place. Sobe coming in. Sobe. It's shinny hockey now. Everybody trying to do it himself. So they missed the net by an inch. Now in back of the net, Green. Dory's penalty is over, so he's on. And Quebec has a one-man advantage. Bobby Smith gets ready to come out. Stone Goulet given Quebec a 2-0 lead. It was almost a replay of the game in Quebec City where he was eyeball to eyeball with Penny. This time he beat him.
Well, this is a dead giveaway by Larry Robinson. There's Goulet coming in. It hit the handle of a stick. That's just the brakes. And he tucked it underneath Steve Penny. 2-0. Boy, that could be a very, very large goal. The first of the series by Michel Goulet. And once again, from a high angle look, the only two guys in the play, Robinson and Goulet. And that stoppage in play brings Bobby Smith back onto the ice. So we're four skaters aside now.
Quebec's goal score unassisted by number 16, Michel Goulet, at 2 minutes, 2 seconds.
Michel Goulet at 2:02. So 2-0, Mickey. And the referee now over talking to the minor officials at the penalty bench. There is going to be some more confusion before this is finished. We have Don Cherry in the booth with us now. Don, it's been a while since we've seen something like this in Stanley Cup action.
Yes, I think the last time when the Bruins were in there, there used to be a few fisticuffs, but nothing you can do about it. That's the way it goes. And I don't think anybody went for coffee while it was on.
Okay, now they're four aside at the moment. Quebec is leading by a goal, and they're on the move again. Long shot. Whistled by Penny's right ear. Paimon, green bump, Carbonell, smooth skating centerman for the Canadians. Got it ahead. Chelios on the move. Chelios going in. Chelios centered it. Went back to Carbonell. Carbonell now trying to throw it in front. Couldn't. Marwall lead pass. Knocked back to Paimon. Smart move by Savard. Paimon faked the shot. Cuts for the net. Wolf Paimon around the net. Taking a look back. Paimon. Rolled it in front. Savard is tied up by Chelios. Green. Nearing the 3-minute mark of the third. 2-0 is the score. Quebec getting a goal here in the third period. Price brings it out. Pass to Savard. From center, he fired it in. Into the corner. Cote Robinson draped him a bit. Robinson couldn't come up with it, though. Cote bumped again. This time by Steve Schutt. And Penny will hang on to it.
There is a look at Gosling, the young goaltender, came to the Nordiques late in the season.
Who's got a knee injury, by the way.
Yes, he does.
I thought he was finished for the season, but they got to pull out all the stops.
Well, of course, Sevigny for Montreal and Malarchuk for Quebec were given game misconduct. The spare goaltenders, they fought two or three times in this melee.
What does this, Don, do to the momentum of the game? We had such fast hockey in that period, second period.
Right after this face-off, I'll tell you what should have been done.
We'll wait for your answer as the Canadians lose it. Doré, in front it comes. McKechnie skating miles there, but Robinson took him to the ice. Canadian start out. Robinson with Bobby Smith getting the pass. Bobby Smith up over the line. Smith gets set from the back. Ludwig. Stopped by Bouchard. Out come the Nordiques. Robinson. He has played two games tonight. He's still on there. Doré fired it in. Ludwig back. Right wing pass. Bobby Smith. Smith on the boards over there. He was given a ride. 2-0 Quebec. Goulet fell. Marwall lost it. Players sprawling after that puck. It's a hot potato and they want it. Robinson has it. Played it ahead. Dropped back again and Marwall. Nordiques organizing. They played 4 minutes, 10 seconds of the third period. 2-0 is the score. Quebec leading. Off into the corner, Robinson. Walter. Walter tried to knock it back. Smith coming in. Smith on the boards, hangs on to it. Bouchard stepping out. Nearly gave it to Guy Lafleur, who's on there quickly. Now the Nordiques on the move again, and Anton Stastny with Sauvé. Anton Stastny tried to win back to Sauvé. Anton Stastny, and he missed that high shot. Not by much, though. Guy Lafleur putting on the Rockets. Nice pass down the wing. Carbonell up in.
lobbing it in, and that'll be called a glove pass. They want a penalty called against Quebec. But the no penalty called. This is a partisan crowd, of course. We'll be back after this.
The point called them down. Of course, they're going to yell at anything here in this building. And now we're finally back to five aside, five skaters aside. 15 minutes to play.
Still 2-0. Quebec. Joule got the second goal here in the third as Doré goes in now with McKechnie in front. He tried to play it over to McKechnie and Chelios made a brilliant defensive move. Falling in front of the pass. Naslund scooped it out. Pass ahead, Mondu. Mondu in on the right wing. He was stopped, but Walter carries on. Walter off into the corner and two Nordiques all over him. They prep the puck there. And there's no further play.
Look at Ryan Walter. He likes to use those corners down there. The Canadians now and Quebec both with very few players on the bench when they've got everybody on the ice.
Now for you people who have been watching that Western game, this is Bob Cole, Mickey Redmond, and Don Cherry at the Forum in Montreal. And it's 2-0 for the Quebec Nordiques. A wild eruption of fighting at the end of the second period. When the teams came back on to start the third period, they were skating around and it broke out again. There have been numerous misconducts. We'll relay some along to you when we get an opportunity. But the score in the sixth game, Quebec trying to tie the series at 3 apiece. It's 2-0. A goal in the first period by Peter Stastny and Goulet here in the third. Now Gainey coming in. Gainey on the board, fired it into the corner. Carbonell. On the other side, Wesley, and it goes over the glass into the crowd. Quebec game misconducts in this game. Peter Stastny, Slager, Dale Hunter, Weir, and a backup goaltender, Malarchuk. Montreal, Nyland, Tremblay, Mark Hunter, McPhee, and the backup goaltender, Sevigny. Quebec, 137 minutes in penalties. Montreal, 118 minutes in penalties. And Don Cherry, it has been a wild few minutes here at the Forum.
Well, what's happened? I've been involved in a few of these, as you know. A note should have been sent to the dressing room saying these players do not return to the ice as they've had game misconducts and misconducts. Yet I had no problem because you know they were after Slager, after what he did to Hamel.
He hit Hamel and knocked him out. In that first big fight, which erupted at the siren to end the second period. And then somebody looked for Slager in the skate. Here's a break for shot in score!
What a shot by Steve Schott. He let a bullet go. Here's a look at it from right behind him. Watch that top corner. That is the 60-goal scorer that we've seen in the past. Steve Schott, who has not played all year for Montreal, picks up that loose puck, and does he drill it down to that top corner with Bouchard down?
Yeah, Dory got caught up at the red line. He should never have done that. But that looked like a Steve Schott of the old, breaking it in there, putting it in the top corner.
Oh, did he ever let a bullet go? Steve Schott with an off year for Montreal, only 14 goals all year long. But back in 1976-77, Steve Schott had a 60-goal year, and certainly that was the kind of shooting that he showed that season, and a big goal here for Canadiens.
Canadiens goal scored by number 22, Steve Schott.
6:23, the time of that goal by Schott.
Assisted by number 15.
Marawa took a shot, tipped near the net. The rebound is there. Into the corner is Goulet. Back near the line, a penalty coming up against Goulet and the Quebec Nordiques. And the Canadiens fans are going wild. They'll go on the power play in an effort to tie this game.
Canadiens
With the score, Quebec 2, Montreal 1, we will have more Stanley Cup playoff excitement after this message.
Here's a look at an isolated Bouchard. That thing hit that left skate and trickled right between his legs. This place is absolutely on fire.
She's ablaze.
Now they're playing hockey. They had to get that out of their system. It was an ugly incident. The second one. Now they're ready to play hockey.
8 seconds left in the Goulet penalty. Canadians looking for a power play goal. 4 seconds left on the power play. It's done now. Goulet is on the ice. It's 2-1. Quebec nearing the 9-minute mark of the third period. Smith with Schutt, who got the Canadian goal. And Steve Schutt in with Naslin. Stopped up the line by Marois. Gave it away. Naslin coming in. Smith behind him. Marois after Naslin. Hit the little fellow in on the boards, but he's still going. Scores!
Listen to this place. Said it. The little guy did it, Bob. You described him as a little guy. He made the play, Don. Well, a lot of guys take that puck around back of the net and center it when they get around. Naslin dumped it out as he went around an old Henry Richard play, and there was 22 again.
Richard moved off the post. Now you know why Hunter went after Slager. Now you know why Mark Hunter went after Slager. Show that courage and get back. They're not going to do that to Canadians. Look at
see,
that.
See Bouchard turn his head?
Yeah.
He turned his head just enough, thinking that Naslin was going to take it around back of the net. He dumped it out before he went back, and Steve Schutt, with only 2 goals in the playoffs coming into tonight's game, gets his second of the night to tie this hockey game.
Schutt from Naslin and 9-11. Now, let me tell you, folks, you see the crowd standing and roaring. When they announced this goal here at the Forum, they put a new roof on this place and renovated the place in 1968. I hope that they put heavy steel up there because it's gonna lift.
Steve Schutt had ripped his sweater off this year. You think he's a happy guy right now?
Canadiens goal scored by number 22, Steve Schutt. Avec l'aide numéro 26, assisted by number 26, Mats Näslund. At 9:11 seconds. 9:11,
and we're tied at the Forum. At 2, Sauvé, Goulet, and his shot deflected into the crowd. Again, we welcome you viewers who have been watching Calgary and Edmonton to this hot cliffhanger at the Forum in Montreal. Bob Poe here with Mickey Redmond, Don Cherry, along with Dick Irvin. We got a tied hockey game for you now. Steve Schutt scoring 2 goals here in the third period after Goulet had given the Nordiques a 2-0 lead. Schutt has tied the game. One at 6:23 and the other at 9:11. Just a minute ago, the Nordiques and the Canadiens in this game 6 tied. At 2, here's Schutt again. Schutt breaking for the net, driving hard. Can't get in. Bob Smith centered it. Cleared away by LaPointe. 9:45 to play in the third period. This is McKechnie with Savard. Ludwig fell to the ice. Back of the net, Will Paymaugh. Here is McKechnie getting it loose. McKechnie turning into the corner. Paymaugh again. Lost it. Andu lost it to Paymaugh. Kept it in. Sauvé. He's covered and cannot shoot it. The Canadians are coming out again. Mondu, it was Smith dropping it up the line. Offside. It is called. Smith's skates were outside the line when he played it. This Stanley Cup playoff game is coming to you from the Forum in Montreal. 9 minutes and 18 seconds left in the third period. The score is tied at 2. Here's one of the Canadiens' backup goaltenders, 7. He got a game misconduct. Wamsley is on the bench now as the backup. Gosselin, who is supposed to be out for the season on a knee injury, is the backup for the Quebec Nordiques because Valarchuk got a game misconduct in the melee that broke out at the end of the second period. And then round two, as they were coming out to start the third period. Chelios trying to knock it loose back there in his own zone. The Nordiques. In forward is Anton Stastny. He and Côté get the puck out. Côté looked back to the line. Anton Stastny tried to center it to Sauvé. Chelios will hit him. Chelios scooped it ahead. Dore is back. Gainey is in. Carbonell coming. Gainey inside the line to Robinson. And a shot. He had to hurry. It was wide. Lafleur left it. A high rising shot grabbed by Bouchard. He got rid of it. 8:25 to play in the third period. Scored tied at 2. Quebec were leading. 2-0 at 1 point. Canadians. Bobby Smith going after Price. The two teams dog tired, but still fighting every inch of the way. Here in game 6 at the fourth. Dore, a pass ahead. The Nordiques unable to get that pass. It was Côté. Dore again. Coming out. Got a pass ahead through the middle. That is stopped. Bobby Smith took it away from Sauvé. The Nordiques changing. Bobby Smith made a good move. Coming in is Smith. A pass back to Green. Look out! Score!
Look out.
Bouchard just shook his head after. Look at his shot from behind the net. A clear open shot, and he beat him clean on the high side. But what a play by Smith. He had everybody sucked back into the Quebec zone. Watch him go back in, and he drops it back to the trailer.
Now watch the defense in front. His own defenseman waves the stick up there, and he distracts. See how he gets the stick up there? You should never do that, you young guys. Never do that.
Carbonell upended. Carbonell back on his feet. It's 3-2, Canadians.
Canadiens goal was scored by number 5, Rick Green. Avec l'aide numéro 15.
Marion Stastny now. 15. Another shot on goal, Bobby, and that's knocked away in behind the net. And the play is called.
14 seconds at 12 minutes, 14 seconds.
Live on CBC, this is Stanley Cup 84. .723 remaining in the period. Three to two, Montreal. Face off to the right of the Canadian net. Smith thrown out. Quick backhander is wide of the goal. Dore tried to keep it in and did. Out for Walter. And Gainey coming in. Gainey gets a chance. Missed the net by a couple of feet. Chelios. Dore played it ahead. Savard now. Couldn't get by Lafleur. 6:50 to play. Lafleur is feeling it. Lafleur finding some room. Lafleur coming in, left it there inside the line. Canadians now starting to look a bit stronger with that lead goal. Here's Lafleur with Chabot, scores!
4-2 now, and this place is going to be worth, who knows, 2-3 goals. The Canadians, I haven't heard them make this kind of noise in this building for many, many years. The Fleur fans on the puck, goes right to Chabot, and he's on that backhand, and he gets it underneath Bouchard. Four unanswered goals by the Canadians. Michel Bergeron down has got to be absolutely pulling his hair out right now. Just not even 10 minutes ago, he had a 2-0 lead.
Well, I know I mentioned about Mark Hunter, and a lot of people will say out there, what's going on? What happened to Mark Hunter? Why would he do that? They were in the dressing room. They saw Hamel laying there. He said, we're going to do something about it. We're going out on our tail.
Compte par le numéro 29. Canadiens goal scored by number 29, John Chabot.
You notice down there now, Don Cherry, the Quebec players with their heads hung.
So they should. The trucking. I've been through this a few times.
First playoff goal for John Chabot.
.27 the time of that goal. 6:15 to play in the third period, and the Canadians now, having been down 2-0, are up 2 goals, 4-2. The national news will follow this hockey telecast, and this has been a hot one here in the Forum in Montreal tonight. Green in back of the net, dumped it into the corner. Goulet stole it, got it back to Wesley. Price, he took a shot, rebound is there. Another shot hit the side of the net. Goulet, Penny is gonna be tough now. A shot blocked by Carbonell, and Walter will lug it out. Carbonell going in with Deeney. A shot's good.
Things now. That's going to do it. 5:32 to go, and Carbonell sneaks it in underneath Bouchard. The Nordiques coach with everybody up trying to get back in a hockey game, which they've got to do, and that makes them vulnerable back at the other end, and it's a 2-on-1. He used Gainey as the decoy and pulled it out.
Well, that's what happened. He wanted to pass it to Gainey, but the defenseman played it perfect. He, no way he could pass it. Bouchard's shot could have come out at him, but hey, it's easy for us to say here. Perfect shot. Carbonell didn't even know he put it in. He looked, is it in?
You're right, though. He did want to pass it to Gainey. That's Carbonell's third playoff goal, and what a series he's had.
Canadiens goal scored by number 21, Yves Carbonell.
Penny covers up on that shot. The scoring play, Carbonell from Ludwig at 14:28, 5-2 Montreal.
Penny makes a route.
Ryan Walter.
Penny makes a routine save, and he gets a standing ovation.
Well, Don, as you pointed out, you know, you've been in this building when things like this have happened. This is incredible. What a comeback. 5 straight goals by Canadians. It looked like they were down and out, 2-0. It was all Quebec. They were beating each other all over the ice, and all of a sudden, it's 5-2 Montreal. And this crowd is, I mean, what can you say?
Well, there you are. Like I said, it was going to throw one team off. It's either going to be Canadians thrown off, or it was going to be Quebec. Quebec's rolling along nice, and all of a sudden, they get thrown off their game. Fight, hurt, Quebec, because they, Canadians were doing nothing up until the time of the fight.
Great.
Walter drew the assist on the Carbonell goal and not Ludwig. Direction on that scoring play, the fifth goal for Canadians. Nordiques now with 5 minutes left to play. They're starting to sink at the Forum. That may be premature. Canadians now are fighting back there to get the puck out of the zone. It's kicked loose. Anton Stastny on the corner boards. It comes back. A long shot high off the glass. Lapointe trying to slap it in. Lafleur will play it out. Yes, he does. Carbonell again, who just had a goal, coming in. Carbonell in front, it goes. Lafleur's tied up.
Savard behind the net, starting out. Anton's Marion Stastny, rather. Marowal lost it. And it's a high stick making contact. It's 5-2, Montreal with 4:23 to play. Wesley tipped it ahead. The Canadians running out the clock, and they have 4 minutes now to eat up in this hockey game. An amazing comeback by Montreal, trailing 2-0. When it looked as if it was all over, it just began. Shot with two, Green, Chabot, and Carbonneau followed. Chabot is in there again. 3:40 to play in the third period, and the Canadians now on the brink of moving ahead against the Islanders of New York. That should be a great series if this score stands up as it is right now. 3:25 to play in the third period. Mondeau is in. Across the line, hooked it in front, and Price takes over. Sauvé out to Côté. Sauvé again to Paimon. Shot, score!
Power shot, power shot.
Don't go away.
Well, Michel Bergeron feels the same way, Bob. Will Paimon, Don, you're exactly right. He had nowhere else to go with it. He just wound up and put everything he had behind it. Again, Montreal defense sucking back in, and it went right up underneath the arm of Steve Penny. That puck, if it had been a regular shot, doesn't go in the net, but with the force that Paimon had on it, it goes through.
He's got a heavy shot.
Yep.
Now watch that goal. He had it.
Yep.
Nothing he can do. I tell you, if it hit somebody's arm, drives them back into the net.
That's the old saying. If you can't put it around him, put it through him.
I saw another guy do that for Detroit a couple of times, about 52. Put it, drive it at him as hard as you can, because like you say, nowhere to go.
Quebec's goal, scored by number 27. We print the Pema avec l'aide numéro 15, assisted by number 15, Jean-François Sauvé, aide numéro 19, and number 19, Alain Côté.
The Nordiques are in there again. But Lafleur sends Gainey out. Gainey to center, slapped it in. Sauvé and Côté assisting on the goal by Pema at 16:51. Anton Stastny through the middle to McKechnie coming up. McKechnie going in. It's a 5-3 hockey game, and the Canadiens, Lafleur. Very prominent in his third period, Lafleur. To Carbonneau, to Lafleur. Up the line, and Gainey has to come back. Canadiens are up 2 goals. They do not want to make a mistake and get caught up the ice. 2:15 to play. Canadiens at 2-on-1. Gainey in with Chabot. He circles. Feeds it in behind the net and races over to the Canadian bench in an effort to get a fresh man on. 2 minutes left to play. A 2-goal spread for Montreal. Sauvé going in. Oh, a close call by Goulet. Robinson now. That has the crowd buzzing. That chance. Off Naslund. 1:45 to play. Canadians trying to hang on for dear life now. They're up 2 goals. Can win the series if they manage to hang on. Paimon faking the shot. Now let it go and hit Ludwig. 1:30 to play. Another shot. Knocked down, and the Canadians will clear it. Chabot is away. Chabot coming in. Chabot's shot stopped by Bouchard. 1:20 to play. Pass ahead. This is Sauvé again coming in. Sauvé with Paimon. Paimon sees Côté. Tried to hit him, and Smith grabbed it. 1:10 to play. Mondeau knocked to the center ice. 1:05 to play. Listen to the crowd when they announce 1 minute remaining in the third period. Last minute, last hope for Quebec. Shot upended. The referee turning the other way. Sauvé coming in. And a shot to the crease, 40 seconds to play. Bruce Hood has had a busy night tonight. These two teams have put on every kind of a show this evening. The Canadians will win it. 25 seconds to play. Carbonneau in there, Robinson in there. And the music starts at the forum, and the singing begins. with 15 seconds now, the Canadians will eliminate the Quebec Nordiques and win the Battle of Quebec.
Well, there's the strangest one of all. Michel Bergeron yelling and hollering to Bouchard. He's not even watching him. He wasn't even watching him, and he's going crazy. Michel hollering over there. Boy, oh boy, that would drive me nuts trying to get a guy out of there like that. You know what? Let me tell you why Shutt was out there on that last shift. Jacques Lemaire knows he's a player that's trying to get them the hat trick.
Bouchard still in the net, looking at Penny and the Canadians with only 12 seconds to go. And I guess Michel Bergeron feeling that it's all over, being down by two goals, is not going to bother getting Bouchard out at this point.
Goulet made it 2-0 Quebec, then two by Shutt, tied it. Green made it 3-2, that looks like the winner. Chabot, Carbonneau, and then Paymon make Chabot's goal the winner.
5 seconds left. The countdown is on. The Montreal Canadiens have defeated the Quebec Nordiques here at the Forum. And you people who have been watching the Western game, we welcome you now to the Forum in Montreal. It's over. The Canadiens are jubilant. The Quebec